Good evening, sisters. So chapter, we're now moving to chapter 7. So the title of the chapter is Dwell Safely in Christ, tama no, your refuge. So yung reference nito is because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High. Yung Lord dyan is Yahweh. Tapos even the Most High is Elyon, God Almighty, your dwelling place. No evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. Psalms 91:9-10. Father God, we thank you because your eyes are upon us forever and always. We thank you that your kindness is towards us. We thank you that you have given us your very best, our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, Lord, we are one with him. And now, Lord, we are made his temple. We thank you, Lord, that we are kings and priests in your name. We are kings and priests because of the finished work of Jesus Christ. Lord, as we walk in this life, Lord, there are many, many things, but there's only one thing that you want us to know, that, Lord, you have made us your dwelling place because of the finished work of the cross. We expect so much, Lord. Lord, as we are experiencing, Lord, your goodness, we are so sure that all the rest of our lives, grace and mercy shall follow us. Thank you, Lord. This is our declaration. This is as it is declared in the scripture. We say amen. In Jesus' name, amen. You made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. So dito muna tayo, no, yung first half. So our wrong understanding of God's nature keeps us always searching and waiting. So meron tayong mindset of Christians like from before, no? But praise the Lord, through the week in Bible study na ginagawa natin as we dig into the Word, wala na tayo dun sa someday mindset. Kasi meron tayong the best is yet to come. So kailan mangyayari yon? Yung someday mindset. But the Lord is saying is it has happened. And we are to partake of His goodness. Because it's not something that we are asking for permission from. It is already given. It is only the only imperative is for us to take lambano, for us to receive. Diba? So yung wrong understanding natin sa kanya na meron tayong, kailangan may gawin ako. God is requiring me to do these things. It keeps us asking God to do what He has already done. It keeps us begging from God, begging God to do what He has already done. He has already given. So, ano ba yung gospel? Ano ba yung finished work? Ito yon. So to believe that Christ's work on the cross is a finished work is to believe that God did not make believers to be alone, but to be with Him. So the clarion call, right? The result of the finished work of Jesus Christ is ultimately for you and for me to be with Him, to be in Him. So ngayon, kaya pala sinabi ni Lord kay Father Abraham, di ba? Live in constant awareness that I'm with you. Because there in your awareness that He is with you, you will see His blessings. Hallelujah. So, no believer lives for himself or from himself, but he lives with God. Live in constant awareness that I am with you. So yung bago natin puntahan yung intro ko pa lang yan. So yung bago dun sa, magdudwell ako dun sa dwelling place. So review lang natin yun. The word refuge, makase. Refuge, kasi may refuge na who is my refuge. Even the Most High, my dwelling place. So yung refuge dyan is makase, which comes from the root word kasa, which during the time of Moses, who is believed to be the author of this psalm, carried the idea of atonement. So, the atonement of Jesus Christ is your refuge. The atonement that was provided at the cross is your refuge, is your guarantee. Hallelujah. Bakit mo masasabi na God is good? Because of His atonement. Because of the finished work of Jesus Christ. Thus, to obtain all this wonderful protection and shelter, you must find, you must understand your atonement in the Lord from the Most High. Hallelujah. So tingnan natin ha, yung Psalms 91 verse 9. In the interlinear, because you, Yahweh, Yahweh is the covenant-keeping name of God. Remember that you're not an ordinary person. You are in covenant with God, who is my refuge. Even the Most High have made your dwelling place. You know, when you click this, your dwelling place, ang ibig diyang sabihin is, in the Hebrew is ma'on or ma'in, dwelling, habitation. Yan. You are now made the habitation of the Lord. Diba? You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. So in the Strong's Exhaustive Concordance, anong ibig sabihin niya? Sabi ganun, then you are the dwelling place. You are the habitation. That's, actually, next week, meron pang, hindi ko na lang siningit dito, but meron pang isang facet na meaning tong maon at saka main. Pero for now, let's continue. So, main, from the same as ona, an abode of God, you are the abode. You are the address. You are God's address here on earth. You know that? Pag tinanong si Lord, no? Name, Elyon, di ba? El Elyon, Yahweh, address, and the faith. Oh, di ba? Address, Joe Padua. Address, Ella Ordilio. Address, JC Coronel. You are His address. Hallelujah! His retreat, His asylum, His den, His dwelling place. And then pag clinic mo yan, ang ibig sabihin itong ano, no, yung Hebrew, ona, yung pinaka-original, ona. Ona. Diba? You know that the meaning of dwelling place is marriage? Ah! Diba? Pag sinabi mo sa Lord na, you are my dwelling place, right? You are saying, I'm married to you. Hallelujah. So, ang ibig sabihin ng ona, cohabitation with conjugal rights. One man and one woman united in the bond of marriage before God. So, they now enjoy the undefiled bed of marriage, which is only for this man. What are conjugal rights? Di ba ang ibig sabihin nito, what is yours, and what is yours is His. So as He is, so are you in this world. Everything that He has is yours. Hallelujah. Sabi nga ni Tom Cruise dun sa ano, no? You know that the Lord is saying this to you? You complete me. You complete me. Because He is married to you and I. Hallelujah. And in Ezekiel 43 verse 11, if you are not convinced, the Lord is saying to you and I, and if they be ashamed of from all that they have done, whatever it is that you have done, show them the form of the house. Alam mo, the Lord is really good, no? Kasi for Him, it is already done, it is already finished. As far as He is concerned, you are clean, you have been made the righteousness of God in Christ. We are the house of God. Ano yung form? We are the house of God, His dwelling place. So when we miss it or are ashamed from what we have done, we need to be reminded or shown who we are in Christ. Who we are in Christ, you are His ona. You are His marriage. You complete Him. Hallelujah. So, yung fashion dyan, yung, ayan ha, yung form, no, kaya ako ina-italicize, yung fashion dyan is the Hebrew word tsura. So to form or to fashion, we were fashioned and formed in His image and likeness. Diba? When God breathed into Adam, right? Diba? Adam was created in the likeness and image of God the Son, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. We were formed and fashioned with the divine nature like our Creator. And the root of the form of tsur or tsura is tsur, meaning to be delineated, which means the exact possession or a border or boundary. In Ephesians 1:5, it says that we were predestined. Our boundaries were marked out beforehand as sons. That's why no evil can befall you, because you are created with exact position or boundary. You are predestined. Hallelujah. So when someone around you doesn't know who they are, because all they can see is what they do or what they have done, and they are burdened with the condemnation of what they have done that has caused them shame, show them the form of their house. They are sons. You are sons. You are daughters with the divine nature made in the image and likeness of Abba. What you have done doesn't define you. Again, what you have done doesn't define you. The one who defines you is only Abba. The one who defines you is only Jesus. Only He defines us. Hallelujah. Remember, di ba, you take on His name. That just like when we get married here on earth, you take on the name of your husband. We are to take the name of our husband, who's our Lord Jesus Christ. So, the answer when we are in doubt, when we are feeling condemned, when we are feeling ashamed, is to hear. To hear again and again what the Spirit has always been testifying to our spirits. To hear who we are in God's eyes. The one He has completely given Himself to in marriage. The answer is to hear again and again what the Spirit has always been testifying to our spirits. To hear who we are in God's eyes. The one He has completely given Himself into marriage. From the moment you are married, it is no longer you, it is no longer I, but it has become us. From the moment you are married, it is no longer you, it is no longer I, but us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 6:16, as God has said, I will live with them and walk among them, and I will be their God, and they will be my people. You know, yung in dyan is the word en in Greek. Yan. En meaning in. A lot of translations use the word with and among in this verse. But the word en means in and denotes a state or condition of rest. It does mean with, but only in the context of within, as in the condition in which something operates from inside. So again, it's a state or condition of rest. So when you say, I am in Christ, I am resting in Christ. God has said, I dwell in them and I walk in them. So to walk is to walk around. It is a Hebraic term meaning to conduct life, to be conversant, to live. So what is the meaning of God is in you? God is at home in you. At rest in you. He walks around in you, conducting His life in you, conversing with you in you. He lives in you. So another meaning of the word dwell in Greek, which is met. You know that God is met in you? So parang God has completed, has found His completion in you. God is met in you. God, you meet God in you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, Galatians 1:15 to 16, it pleased God who separated me from my mother's womb and called me by His grace to reveal His Son in me. And in Acts 17:27, to this pagan idol-worshipping Greeks, that they should seek the Lord, if haply they might feel after Him and find Him, though He be not far, not at a distance from every one of us. Because God is not a God of distance. God is met in us. We are His habitation. We are His home, His dwelling place, His resting place. God has found His rest in loving you. God has found His resting place in you and I. Hallelujah. It is finished. So, the Lord is saying to you, thou art fair, my love. There is no spot in you. Thou art fair, my love. There is no spot in you. Song of Solomon's 4:7. So church, where is your accuser? He has been disarmed, for his weapon, the accusations of the law, has been nailed to the cross. Church, Where is your accuser? He has been disarmed for his weapon. The accusations, the condemnation of the law has been nailed to the cross. So not everyone is walking in the understanding of who they are as sons and daughters in the image and likeness of God. Designed to rule and reign in life as victorious, life-giving, love-releasing sons and daughters. So how do we minister to each other? Ezekiel gave us some great advice. In Ezekiel 43 verse 11, it says, and if they be ashamed from all that they, yung kalahati din is kasi natin, ano? From all that they have done, show them the form of the house and the fashion thereof, and the goings out thereof, and the comings in thereof, and all the forms thereof, and all the ordinances thereof, and all the forms thereof, and all the laws thereof, write it in their sight, that they may keep the whole form thereof, and all the ordinances thereof, and do them. In essence, what Ezekiel is trying to say to us is this: to those who are ashamed of all they've done and confused from living light out of mistaken identity instead of living as exalted sons with a divine nature to rule and reign on this earth, living instead in awareness of the lower realm, incomplete from less than their divine nature, we show us who God says they are. So we are not to bring an awareness of sin to those living as less than God designed, those we have called sinners. We are to simply to show to them the house and show them who God says they are in Him. We are to simply show them the house and show them who God says they are in Him. Ano yung show them the house? Sila yon, di ba? Yung temple. Di ba tayo? Show them who God says they are in Him. In other words, God says to us, make known to each other. Make known or teach each other to be intimately acquainted with the house, with who they are as my house, my dwelling place, the abiding place of the Father, Son, and the Spirit. Make them intimately familiar with their design of divinity made in my image and likeness. Show them their arrangement, their perfection, completeness, fixed place in Christ. Reveal to them that their boundaries, their horizons were marked out in sonship before time began. Tell them that I chose them in Christ before the foundations of the world as eternally blameless and holy. Face to, pag sinabing holy, di ba? Whole. No sickness. Whole. Di ba? Face to face with the Trinity in love, let them know that they were predestined, called, justified, glorified, from before time began. So, we reveal to them that the sum of all things is that Christ is seated at the right hand, and they are seated with Him, we are seated with Him. Make known their entrances and exits, their comings and goings. Let them know they are fully blessed going in and just as blessed going out. That nothing they could do changes that. Tell them that they are filled with the fullness of me, and they are in me, and I am in them. And as for all the house ordinances and laws, those were nailed to the cross. And the only law they need to be concerned about is the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus. And make known, write it in their sight, engrave it in their minds and hearts, so that this can be the revelation that in Christ they are whole, their design is complete. And that in Christ all the statutes and ordinances are done, it is finished, and reassure them that there's no more war, no more for them, nothing to do but to rest in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So, lastly, alam niyo na naalala ko to the other day, and you know what? It has impacted me so much. This song, this very old song, right? It is actually the gospel. Oh, the glory of your presence, we your temple give. Pero yung una, Jesus, O glorious, create in us a temple called a us living stones, where you're enthroned. As you rose from death to life, so you rise within our worship. Rise upon our praise, and let the hands that saw you raise, you've clothed us in your glory. You've drawn us by your grace. All the glory of your presence, we your temple give you rest. So eyes to your and be blessed by your praise as we glory in your embrace. As your presence now fills this place, Father God, we thank you that indeed you have filled this temple. You have filled this temple with your wholeness, with your completeness. And so we arise with the resurrection life that you have so infused in us. We thank you, Lord, that everything that we touch is life. Everything that we touch is wholeness. And in us, Father, it is declared whole. It is declared complete. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Amen. Let's take our communion elements. And tonight, let's remember what Jesus did for us at the cross. Lord, today as we lift up the bread, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for the word that you have for us today. That because you, Jesus, have been bruised, have been beaten, he was chastised for us. He was broken for us so that today we can declare ourselves healthy, whole, complete, and we became the dwelling place of Amen. You, Lord. And we thank you. Now we can declare that because you're our dwelling place, no evil or any plague come near us because we are your dwelling place. And the life that lives in our body is the life that flows in you right now. You are our life, Jesus. And we thank you. We declare ourselves completely whole, completely healed, completely restored and renewed from the crown of our heads to the soles of our feet. Every single cell in our body is healthy and well. We partake the bread. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Now let's lift up the cup. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, thank you for shedding your blood for us. Your blood has made us righteous forever. Because of your blood, we have been accepted in the Beloved. And because of your blood, we became one with you.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, because we have this relationship with you more than we have ever expected. And it blows our mind how much you have loved us and how much perfectly you've seen us. You see us right now because of Jesus' blood. So Jesus, we thank you. And we declare tonight all the blessings that crowns Amen. Your bride, which is preservation, restoration, healing, wholeness, and all your blessing manifesting in our lives, manifesting in our bodies, manifesting on the in the lives of the people around us, simply Amen. Because you love us. Let's partake of the wine.
Amen.